Hi, today is April 15th, 2020, and I have a friend here with me today. Come on out, Leonard. This is Leonard Bernstein, and he wanted me to help him share about his life with you. So pay close attention, because when we get done telling you about his life, I'm going to have a little challenge for you to do at home. So this is Leonard Bernstein. He was born on August 25th, 1918. Maybe some of you out there were also born in August. And he was born in Lawrence, Massachusetts. Massachusetts is a state in the United States. His parents came to the United States from Russia. When he was 10 years old, his family was given a piano. And as soon as they got that piano, he started to play the piano. And he played the piano so much and loved it so much that he decided when he got to college he would study music. So he studied music in college. He continued to play the piano. And he also learned how to conduct. So that's why he's got this baton in his hands. That's what conductors use to keep the groups together and to show them how to play the music. So he learned how to conduct with his baton. The time that he spent in college studying music and meeting other musicians really had an impact on him and, like, changed the way that he wrote his music or influenced the way that he wrote his music. So the way that he wrote his music had a lot to do with the people that he met and the things he learned while he was in college. So right after college, he was named the assistant conductor of the New York Philharmonic, which is a big orchestra group in New York. That was in 1943. He got his big break just a few months later. He was just the assistant conductor, but the regular conductor was sick for one of their big performances, and so with very little time to prepare or rehearse, he had to step in and conduct the orchestra, and he did an excellent job, so that's where he got his big break. A lot of the 1940s and 1950s, he spent traveling around the United States and Europe, guest conducting other people's groups of musicians, kind of helping them see things from a different way or helping them understand the music in a different way. That was one of the things that he did. He wrote a lot of music for musicals, like on Broadway. And so one of those was very, very popular. You may have heard of it before. It's called West Side Story. He wrote the music for West Side Story. His music was heavily influenced or had a lot of sounds that were similar to jazz. So he was kind of a jazz person. And then the other big thing that he did was he brought music to TV. So he would record sessions where he would teach kids like you things about music, and then they recorded him and put it out onto TVs all over the country so that kids like you could learn from your homes just like you're doing right now. Leonard Bernstein did pass away on October 14th, 1990 in New York. He was 72 years old, and up until the time that he passed away, he got to keep writing music and performing music, so he lived a long life doing what he loved, which is awesome. Okay, that's a lot of information about him, but I hope it was some good information. So now, I want you to think about some of the things that you learned about my friend Leonard here, and go and tell somebody in your house two things that you remember about Leonard Bernstein that I just taught you right now. Okay, tell your cat, tell your sister, tell your stuffed bear, tell somebody two things about Leonard Bernstein, and then also, down in the comments, or down in the description of the video, maybe mom or dad or a brother or sister can help you find it, I posted a link to another YouTube video that is a piece of Leonard Bernstein's music called Candide, and it's him conducting. So you can actually see him conducting and listen to his music, okay? So that link is in the comments. He would love it if you listened. All right, have a great rest of your day.